Okay, so doing a couple of examples. On this first one, there is a little bit of a typo. That shouldn't be there. It's just the 3 that's down below. So CO3 is right here. So the name of that is carbonate. So again, you have to realize it's a polyatomic ion. You can notice it because it has 2 capital letters. If you have 3 capital letters in your compound, there's probably a polyatomic ion in there somewhere. So I have Ca, which is calcium. I can see that here on the periodic table. So I'm going to write calcium. It's the positive ion, right? It's the positive cation, so we use the full name. And then because the anion is a polyatomic ion, we just use its full name as well. So calcium carbonate. We don't change the ending of polyatomic ions. Only if the anion is a monatomic ion, then we change the ending. So for the second one, I can see that there's a break right here. Potassium is my positive one, and then chlorine, Cl, is my negative one. So I only have 2 capital letters there, which means both of those are monatomic. Potassium is right here. Again, I only change the ending of the second one, right? The first one just stays the same, so I'm going to call it potassium. And then Cl is over here, so that's chlorine. The ending of chlorine gets changed to chloride. So the answer is potassium chloride. The next one, I see 3 capital letters, the F, the S, and the O. So I'm going to split that up. I'm going to notice that iron is right here. And I say, uh-oh, I don't know the charge, right? If it winds up being any of these guys, except for the exceptions, right, then I have to write the charge using a Roman numeral. So this one gets a little harder. So I have FeSO4. So SO4, I can see, is a sulfate right here. And I can see that it has a 2- charge. And remember, it has to equal 0. So what does that make iron? 2+. So iron is 2+, and sulfate is 2-, making it 0. So when I name this, Fe is going to be iron, and remember, I need the Roman numeral of the charge. So Roman numeral 2, and then again, I don't change the ending of a polyatomic ion, so I just write the word sulfate. Next one, I have Li and Br. So here is Li, and here is Br. They are both monatomic, so I don't change the first one ever, lithium. And then bromine gets changed into bromide. Again, we drop the I-N-E ending and add I-D-E because it is a monatomic ion. I want to do one more of the Roman numeral ones. So here I have F-E and C-L, right? So 2 capital letters, both monatomic. Let's see. So F-E is here on the periodic table. Again, I notice, oh my gosh, it's in my little box. That means I need the Roman numeral. So iron, and then I say, oh wait, I need to calculate the Roman numeral. So FeCl3. So here is chlorine. I know the charge of chlorine is -1 because it's in that column. If you remember, it was +1, +2, +3, and then -3, -2, -1, which is chlorine, and then 0. So chlorine is -1. There's no 3 on the periodic table, right? It's just Cl. So that means that 3 is there to tell me I have 3 of them. So that I have -1, but I have it 3 times, which means iron has to be +3 in order to make it 0. So iron is 1, 2, 3. And then chlorine, because it's the -1, gets changed to chloride. So again, remember, you're changing the ending of monatomic ions to IDE, but for polyatomic ions, they keep their name. You do not change the ending.